you're broken down and tired of living life on a merry-go-round, and you can't find the fighter. Then I see it in you, so we go work it out. Move mountains, we go work it out. Move mountains, and I'll rise like the day. I'll rise unafraid. And I'll do it a thousand times again. When the silence isn't quiet, and it feels like it's getting hard to breathe, I know you feel like dying, but I promise you, bring the world to its feet. Move mountains, bring it to its feet. And I'll rise like the day. I'll rise unafraid. I'll rise up, and I'll do it a thousand times again. All we need is hope, and for that we have each other, and for that we have each other. Oh. We will rise, we will rise, we will rise, oh, we'll rise. Rise like the day, I'll rise up, rise unafraid, I'll rise up, and I'll do it a thousand times again, for you.
I'm not really having a good day. 1 in 100 teens has dysautonomia, which makes it more common than multiple sclerosis. Yet, none of my doctors knew about it. Until I found one out of dozens who knew. And I guess it gets me thinking, like, this has happened to me, like, if I've come to this such a low point and I've almost taken my life so many times, it makes me think how many other teens took their life because this went undiagnosed. Because I know that if I would have continued to go undiagnosed, I used to be one of my city's top students. I was like the kid that every teacher wanted to get next year. And so you see those trophies up there? Those are from perfect scores on the state test. Only like a few kids every year would get a perfect score on the state test, and I got 3. And now I'm a college dropout. As of right now, I am. I had high hopes to be a neuroscientist. I'm very passionate about neuroscience, which is kind of ironic now that I have a neurological disorder. But if I can't do the things that I thought that I was going to do in life and the things that people expected me to do in life, if I can't do those things, I'm gonna do what I can. That's using my voice. 'Cause this isn't right. If anything, I can let people know that it exists and we're here. It's called an invisible illness. But we're not invisible, we're right here, we're right in front of you. You can't see that we're sick. You can't see our illness, that's why it's called an invisible illness, but it really... The only reason why it's called invisible illness is because we're made to feel like we're invisible. I wish it didn't have to be that way. And I take that back. I don't think it has to be that way. And that's why I'm doing this.